Hi everybody, hello, this is Sun Tsunami, and we're here to talk about an update to the whole Imani situation. Now, if you didn't know about the Imani situation, please watch my last video on the topic. But essentially, if you haven't heard, Imani Khalif is one of the most controversial Olympic stars to date because many people have questioned her gender once the IBA came out and essentially said that she was a man. Now, at first, the IBA stated that Khalif and Lin Yuting were found to have competitive advantages over the other female competitors. So that's why both of them were disqualified when it came to the IBA. It's the same IBA that the International Olympic Committee suspended in 2019 over how they ran their business. And they weren't officially stripped of the recognition until 2023. So they have some bad beef with the IOC, I'm sure. They have made it their point, their whole modus operandi, to discredit Imani and Lin Yuting. And in a recent press conference, I think the president essentially just said that they are men. Just flat out said that they are men. So let's talk about it, because Imani just won gold, and I know it's going to be a controversy. It's already a controversy, but it's going to continue being a controversy. So the most important thing we got to talk about, which I didn't touch on my last video, and the comments made sure that I knew that, was to the whole XY chromosomes. Essentially, the fact that she is intersex. Now, what is intersex? Best way I can describe intersex, using the definitions that I'm seeing here, it's generally used for a variety of situations in where the person is born with reproductive or sexual anatomy that doesn't really fit the boxes of female or male. And I was talking about this with my father. The best way you can describe it is just the hybrid human. An intersex person is essentially a hybridization of a human being. If they have some parts female, some parts male, it's not, you can't fully gender them. That part is true. So when it comes to the, you know, boxing, when it comes to competition, our sports, people don't care if it's a sport where it really is just you. Like, let's say it's table tennis. People are not going to be mad at an intersex person for playing table fucking tennis. They're not going to be like, oh, you have the advantage because your arm is just so much stronger. No. But for stuff like boxing, for stuff like swimming, when it comes to Leah Thompson, she is trans. And when you're trans, it's a whole different thing. You're essentially taking your first gender and switching over to the second gender. If we believe it's just two genders, you're taking what you were, male and or female, and then switching it to the other side. So that means that you're going to have either advantages or disadvantages based on your anatomy. So if you are male to female, you got the upper arm strength, you got the wider body, you know, you're just bigger and larger. So if you're doing competitions that require a woman to be bigger and or larger in order to compete well, like let's say swimming, people are obviously going to talk about it. And in that case, I wouldn't even have to blame them. I would have to agree, because there are clear advantages that the person that is male to female would have versus a woman that is cisgendered. It's clear to see via Leah Thomas and how she, before transitioning, wasn't the best swimmer and now is one of the number one swimmers that was almost on the Olympic track. That's a totally different situation. And that's honestly why she lost the case. Now, when it comes to intersex, you can make a case that, oh, shoot, more of her man self was born versus her woman self, but how do you test that? You can say that because you're just looking at their face and you're being disrespectful, saying, oh, they look like a man, they must be a man, they have to be a man, intersex. But it's way, way more complicated than that. It's way more complicated than that. So I think the best thing going forward, if you have someone that does identify as intersex, or someone that, you know, you can prove that they have the XY chromosome and they're deciding to do a, you know, an event, you gotta do a testosterone test. If that's the biggest issue, if that's the thing that people are fucking worried about the most, you gotta do a testosterone test. Women should have a certain average of testosterone. So if any intersex person reaches that threshold, or let's say goes below it, they should be able to compete. And if they go above it, they should not be able to compete. If that's what we have to do in order for a controversy like this to never happen again, then so be it. Because I understand the complexities of intersex But I also understand the hurt and the pain that a person must go through to be misgendered when they live their whole life as one thing. But the world is denying your existence. And if you can't understand that, then honestly, go fuck yourself. Hey, I'm telling you right now, go fuck yourself. But that's it. That's Sun Tsunami. My mouth is bit. Catch you guys in the next one.